everybody. Welcome back to Rachel Bella Crafts. Rachel here. I hope you're all well. So thank you for joining me today. Today is the 18th of February. It is our last but one weekend in our Tips, Tricks, Hacks 23 collaboration. And it's going really, really well. I hope you're enjoying all of the videos so far. We've had some absolutely fantastic videos. We've had 17 fantastic videos. They have all been absolutely amazing. Before I forget, just wanted to do a quick shout out to Steph at Hilltop View Journals. Now, she is due to put her video up on the 23rd, but unfortunately, poor Steph has not only came down with COVID last week, but then she was also rushed into hospital yesterday to have an emergency operation. So she is okay, she's doing all right, she's on her way home now, but she may or may not get her video up next week. Now, I've told her not to, but you know what these girls are like, they're dedicated to the end. So if she doesn't get her video up on the 23rd, would you mind please going on and just supporting her channel, watching some of her brilliant videos that are there, and then I would suggest it to her, if she really wants to do it, to pop it at the end. And then she'll have had a week or two then to recover, bless her heart. But so get well soon to you, Steph. We all hope that you are feeling better very, very soon. As you all have seen from the title of my video, we are going to be looking at reduce, reuse, repurpose our bling. Now, I am sure most of us, if not all of us, somewhere in your craft stashes have got stuff that looks like this. Yes, that dreaded messy drawer that is full of acquired, shall we say, beads, broken jewellery and just bags of junk that we've picked up in charity shops. Oh, sorry, I didn't mean junk. I meant useful things. Well, it's only useful if we actually use them, isn't it? So my task today is to try and use up some of my messy buckets and bowls and boxes of bling and see how I can repurpose them. So a little project that I've been wanting to try for a couple of months now, I'm going to have a go at today. Now, there's a very little story behind this. At Christmas time, I actually had 3 weeks off work and I set myself the task of trying to learn to crochet. Oh, the least said about that, the better. However, I was unsuccessful only because I didn't have enough time to put into it. Well, that's my excuse anyway, but I'm moving very quickly on. However, thankfully, a very good friend of my son's, she has recently taught herself to crochet. She's a university student and obviously she's picked herself up with a lovely hobby to try and craft her way through uni. What a better way to do it. It turns out she doesn't live all that far from me. So I dropped her a message on her Instagram page and asked her if she would like to knock up some crochet flowers for me. As if you just, you know, because I knew she would be able to do it. She'd learned so quickly. And I asked if she'd mind if I used them in a project on my channel. So before I forget, because I will forget otherwise, her name is Cheska and this is her Instagram page. If you want to go and check her out, this is where you will find her. And if you wanted to order anything from her, you can do so through her Instagram page. So she very, very kindly, she popped in to visit my son the other day and she left these with him and I went and collected them then on the weekend. But how stinking cute are these? Aren't they lush? Look. I'm so excited. I had to just sit on them quietly for a week because I'm desperate to have a go at this video. Now, whether or not this is going to go really, really well or whether it's just going to be a mess, because I'm a little bit all fingers and thumbs, you know that. I have pre-threaded my needles. I am not going to make you painfully sit and watch me attempt to stitch my bling because, oh my goodness, that will be just like pulling teeth for you, I'm sure. Because I will drop them a lot and I will fumble around a lot. So I warn you, I am no pro and I do struggle with threading the beads. But what I have done is made sure that I have threaded a very, very small needle. It came out of this pack. So this is about as specific as I get. And if they are sizes 3 to 9, I am using this one here. That one there. So I don't know. I'm guessing that that's probably size 4 maybe. I'm not sure. I don't know an awful lot about needles. Mum would be the better one to ask. But I just checked that the smallest bead that I want to use will go through, because very often when I'm trying to do things with beads, I start off with this gigungous needle and then wonder why then the beads and things get stuck halfway down my needle, which is quite annoying when you're halfway through stitching a thread, isn't it? And then you've got to unpick it all. So particularly these ones here. So I don't, oh, I'm sorry, but my sequins are everywhere. So I don't know if any of you've got these wheels. Most of you've probably got these wheels. But those really, really tiny little beads in there, can you see those little glass ones? I have terrible trouble picking them up, but once I then get them onto the end of the needle, they very often won't go down the other one, but they will on that size four. So I have tested that. If you wanted to know how big my crochet flowers were, I have brought a little tape measure just to give you a quick measure. So you can see they are approximately 3 centimetres. And these beautiful, aren't these lovely, these sunflowers you made for me. They're slightly bigger and they are 5 centimetres. Okay. Oh, sorry, I should be doing that in inches. You do tell me. I am sorry, I forget. I keep thinking every reason I prefer inches. There we are. 2 inches for the big ones, and the little ones are, they are just, well, yeah, there they are. They're an inch. So there we go. Nice and easy. 1 and 2. Right, so what I plan to do today now is take some of the stuff that I've showed in that photograph in my awful messy boxes, and I am going to try and bling these up. So let me just move this to the side a minute. So these are the items that I've pulled out. Oops, sit by there a minute, flowers, and I'm jumping about. These are the items that I've pulled out. So I've got, this basically just came out of a bag of mixed stuff from a charity shop. I picked up, oh gosh, I think I bought these about a year ago. And I'm gonna just cut this thread, take some of these beads off and see how they look and try and dress up my little flowers. And then I'm gonna show you what I'm gonna do with them. So these I'm really excited about using, because that's a, you know, they're like pearl beads there. And then some of them I'm going to attach some lace to, and I'll show you why in a little while. So I'm going to get set up, make a start, and then I'll be back. Okay, so before I show you what I've been up to, I just want to do a quick commercial break just to remind you, if you've just joined me and you've just somehow managed to randomly stumble onto my channel and you're not aware of what we're doing, this video is actually part of a collaboration. This is the collaboration schedule. You'll see it on our Instagram. It'll be on the first video. There is a playlist that is linked. I will put the link down below for the playlist, but please do go and check out all of these wonderful, amazing artists and crafters, because they have been absolutely fantastic. This video you're watching here is actually for the 18th, so you've missed all of this if you haven't yet caught up with it, okay? So please do go and check it out. They're bringing you tips, tricks, hacks, and all things just journaling and crafting. Oh, there's been some fantastic ideas, so please do go and check them out. Also, if you do enjoy my video today, if I could just ask very kindly, if you wouldn't mind giving me a like and also leaving me a comment, because it does help my channel to grow, and it helps for the algorithm for YouTube, and it just knows then that you like my video, and then it'll promote it a bit more then. So thank you for that. Okay, commercial break over. Looky what we have here. I have been very busy. Now, it may feel like no time has passed at all. In actual fact, a day and a half has gone past since I did the first part of this video. So yeah, I put a bit of time to it, you know. It wasn't, this hasn't taken me a day and a half. I've also been busy doing other things. You know, I've slept, I've ate, I've done some washing, cooked some meals, been to the cinema, you know, as you do. Anyway, I'm waffling. So what I have done is this. I showed you the beads and stuff and the leftover bits of jewellery that I had. And I also showed you these gorgeous little crochet flowers that I'd purchased from Cheska. And I was explaining to you all how I wanted to make some kind of embellishment-y, blingy things to use to, you know, just jazz up my journals and stuff like that. So I've done a variety of styles to give you some different ideas. So I've done some up here that are kind of like vintage-y. So, shall I just bring you in a bit, guys? Hang on. Hey, how is that? Is that better? Can you see a little bit better now? So, these ones up here I've done are of a vintage kind of style. So, what I've done here is I have used some scrappy lace, and I've made a little scrappy lace flower behind that one. I've stitched on the bead, and then that's now become like a little flag cluster thing to go on something in my journal. This one here I have used other bits of scraps. I've got a bit of burlap there, I've got a, oh, it's come off there, a little bit of scrappy lace there, and then I've used some old stained lace there behind, and I've again just stitched on one of those little beads, and there we are, that one's ready to go as well. And then this one here, the same. I've got a bit of burlap, I've got a bit of vintage lace on the back, and then again it'll just make a nice little you know, just a page embellishment kind of thing. So here are a few that I have put some little pearls onto. I glued these ones, two reasons. I got fed up with stitching, it took too long. Yeah, I wanted to get them done, but also just to kind of prove that I used this, sorry, Fabri-Tac. I am a little coffee now this evening because it is quite strong. sorry. So I've used the Fabri-Tac to put those on, and they literally went on in seconds. In fact, I'm kind of covered in the stuff now, but yeah, they've held really well. I've thrown them around the room, slung them at the TV. No, I haven't done that. Wrestled the dog. No, I haven't done that either. But no, they have, they've stuck really well. So I'm fairly confident you're not throwing your journals around. They'll stay in place perfectly fine, or they should anyway. But yeah, I did stitch some on. I did stitch some, let me see if I can find one. I think I've used them. I'll try and show you in a moment, where I've put smaller beads either side. So in that situation, it was easier to kind of use, you know, the stitch, because it was easy to pick them all up. But the small needle that I was explaining to you about earlier on did fit perfectly fine. In fact, the beads, these here, they worked with a larger needle. So that was quite helpful, because my eyes weren't the best this week. This one here, then, I've gone for a bit more of a shabby chic kind of look. So this one here has got a little bit of scrappy lace behind it. And then I've used some of that stuff that I was working with a couple of weeks ago when I did the wispy wings. No, goodness, that was last year. Winter whispers, all this. Yes. So I used some of that under there. It's kind of like a meshy kind of stuff, but it's really nice. It gives a bit of a glistening, silvery effect behind it. And I've literally just clustered up some lace, stitched it all together. Nobody's gonna see the back, are they? And I think that just gave it a bit more of a pop, you know. This one here, I've made a little flag, a bit of a lace behind there, cut it into a little flag shape. Again, you can pop it onto anything, tag, pocket, top of the page. This one here, I've only pinned this one because I literally just found this little ruffle, but I thought, oh, I'll pop that in there just to give you an idea. So you could take a fabric ruffle, pop one at the top, make a perfectly nice embellishment for a page. And this one here as well, I've taken a nice bit of lace applique, and again, to make a bit of a flag kind of shape, I've popped that in there. So all of these are here now waiting to be used. And then the sunflowers, what I actually did with the sunflower was I sat and stitched the beads all around the outside. Then I put some of the really small beads then in the centre to look like, you know, the little stamen bits of the flower where the pollen is. And then I popped this lovely big pearl bead on top. But I love these. I'm going to be using these on a cover of a journal soon. Not quite yet, because I'm not quite at the summer, but I have plans for those. So I'm quite excited. Okay, so that's kind of some of the ways that you can bling them up. Now I'm going to show you a few examples of what I've then done with them after I've blinged them. So bear with. I have a tray. Okay, so these are my little scrappy clusters that I have just simply made using scraps. I had some, I got my big cutter, circle cutter things out with this shape. I'm not sure what they're called. And I cut out some coffee dye paper that I'd embossed, actually. It was just, I thought that would be quite nice. And then I also used my smaller cutter and cut out some of my, actually, I'll tell you what I used. You know, when I do a kit, I do a title page, and I tend to put images from my kits around the title. So I'm using the Letters of Love kit at the moment. So what I actually did was I used my circle cutter and I cut all that up, and I thought even the letters looked cool. So I've literally used everything that I could out of that piece of paper. And then I laid them all out on a big sheet on the floor. I sprayed them with three different types of distress ink. See, I have started using the distress inks already. There's a red one there, there's a blue one there. Please don't ask me for technical names. And I did a bit then of the sort of my favourite finish, antique bronze. So but yeah, I just thought, you know, gives them a bit of colour, you know, judge up your scraps. That one, I love that. Look at the effect on there. That's so cool. And then I had some Edith Holden pages left over, so I just half cut some of those out then. And then I created these. And I think they look really, really cute. What do you think? And I've used a bit of scrappy lace then underneath. And then I've popped on these cutie little flowers on top. But I really like that. I think that'll look quite cute on a page. You can either use that as a tuck behind or just a page embellishment. Now, I know they're quite raised, but, you know, we put a lot of bulk in the journals. You wouldn't have, you know, you would have something that thick in a page section anyway, so you just take that into account when you bind in. And the lovely Lenore, if you watched my last video, you'll remember that she sent me some beautiful presents in with the angel gift stuff. She sent me some pieces for my birthday for next week, and she gave me a bag of this gold leaf. And I thought, oh, that'll be perfect. So I cut some off and I tucked it just behind the little flowers. And I'm really pleased with that. I think that looks super cute. So there are four of those, and I've layered lace underneath and on top. And then there's that one there. That one probably needs to go on a bigger circle, actually. I'd started it like that, I think, and then perhaps if I added on there, that's a bit better then. But there we go. So that's the clusters. I shall move my tray. Then I made this tag tuck. I'm going to call it a tag tuck because it is actually two tags, one on top of the other. And I've used some more of those circles to layer and cluster and layer and one thing or the other. And then I've used, I actually had a little, I'm not sure if it's a snowflake, I'm not sure, stamp. No, yeah, punch, that's the word I'm looking for. So I just punched a bit of coffee paper out. And then I just use a little bit of scrap lace, folded in half to make a bit of a leaf effect. Pop my little crochet thing, a bit of lace under there. Bob's your uncle. But I think it looks great. Imagine that on a page with something tucked down behind. I wouldn't particularly want to use it as a tag just because I've added larger embellishments on, and then popping it in and out of a pocket might be a bit problematic. So I figured if you just wanted to just stick it onto the page, you could have it then as a tuck. And that's why I've just stitched the top there, just to give it a little bit of, you know, make it a bit more stable. So yeah, there's another idea for you there to decorate up your tags. And then the last one that I've got, or the last of the ephemera, this is another corner tuck. I like this one too. So I've taken here one of the journal cards out of one of our kits, and I have added some beautiful lace over the top, stitched around. And then here I've taken some more of those circle things. That's technical, isn't it? My circle cutouts. And I've actually cut them in half to save, I didn't want to waste a, you know, a whole one. Cut it in half, pop one that side, a bit of the Edith Holden one, a bit of the coloured one, and then I've added my little crochet flower, and I've added two of the flowers that, again, Lenore sent me in that lovely little bundle with my paper flowers. And I think that looks absolutely gorgeous. So that's another two ideas here. So some little tuck spots there that you can use decorating with your blingied embellishments. Okay, now this is another idea I had for what I thought you could use your blinged up embellishments for. So what I've done is I'm using this journal just as an example. I haven't actually stuck this down, that's why it's all curling a bit, so please don't be horrified at my application. I was just trying it out. But basically I have just taken an old doily and I've added that underneath. And then I have layered on that then some lace, which I've placed into the centre. And I've then put a large applique flower on there. Actually, I think there's two layers of lace. There's pink and then there's white. And then I had some of these like little applique bits. Mum gave me these quite a while ago. I think, in fact, these were left over from when she made my sister's wedding dress. Oh, goodness, 30 years ago. And she gave me a few of those. So I have been holding them because they're very precious. So they've just sat in a bag. But I thought for today, I will get them out because they look really nice under this. And then I put the big flower in the middle then. This is just, oh my goodness, I think this flower has come from Wish. It's nothing, you know, but dressed up then with these little cutie, I don't know, I just like the different textures, the different, I just think that looks really lovely as a journal cover. So what I would probably do, I was going to suggest I would have done this as a closure. So you would have put a ribbon then under here. So obviously the other half of it wraps around. I've placed some lace over the top, just so that the spine is a bit more interesting. But you could then have ribbon then, and that would tie your thing. But you could then take it off if you wanted to. So I've done that with a journal before. I've made a closure with a decorated doily that you could lift on and off the actual journal, so that when you opened your journal, you weren't kind of like, you know, crushing the beautiful stuff on top. But I don't know. I'm very pleased with that. I think that looked really pretty, and I think it's just a really good way in which you can again use up some of that broken jewellery, that old stuff, the beads and everything else. These are the ones that I did the double beads on. Oh, here we are. That's a better example there. So I'm not sure you can see that. I'll see if the camera will focus a minute. Where are you? There. So can you see that I've put the little ones either side and then the big bead in the middle? So that was what I was talking about earlier on. But yeah, I just think they look really, really cute. So there we go. Where are we? So that is pretty much it for my tutorial today. I didn't want it to be too long or too in-depth because I know you've had a lot thrown at you now. 3 weeks worth of tutorials. You've got plenty of ideas there now to be going on with. Now, if you don't have a Cheska who can make you some beautiful crochet flowers, or if you don't have a... because, of course, you can always... you know, cut these out of things. Very often you'll find that like old blankets and things will have little crochet flowers in. So, you know, try and utilize what you can, where you can. But if you don't have stuff like that, you can do this with other things. You could do this with paper flowers that you can make. You know, there's lots of examples of those. But really the kind of crux of what I'm trying to get over to you now is that there are different ways in which we can be using the stuff that we've got in our drawer, like the broken jewelry, like the beads, the things that for some of us, not all of us, I know some of you are great at utilising those things, but I am very much guilty of it. Like they sit on the shelf, like my buttons, and I just forget they're there. So busy with all the paper. So yeah, I just thought it'd be nice to break out the bling today and just remember that we do like our journals to be pretty and should be shiny. And this is just a really good way in which you can do it. So I hope you enjoyed the video. Please come back for my next one. I just want to say as well, a really big thank you to everybody for all your support over the last couple of weeks. Channel is growing. It's been quite crazy actually, the growth in the last couple of weeks. I think I'm on something like 13,000 something now this morning. So yeah, every day I get up and it's like, what? So yeah, really, really, really grateful. And it's growing because of you guys. It's growing because you are interacting with me. It's growing because you're leaving me lovely comments. And I love opening my emails and seeing all the comments in there. So it's great. I haven't answered them all yet. I'm gonna go and sit and do that tonight while this uploads. But it's lovely, and it's lovely connecting with you all as well. So I just wanted to say a huge thank you to that, because my growth journey is down to you and you alone. So thank you very much. Have a great day. Enjoy your weekend. Make sure you catch up on all the videos, and I will be back with you very soon. Take care now. Bye-bye.